Today we will discuss the topic units and measurement. We know that any systematized knowledge is known as science, and physics is an important branch of science, and physics is the study of nature and natural phenomena. Many natural phenomena are familiar to us. Take the simple example of a freely falling body. So, an object is at a certain height and it is freely falling from this particular height. And this is a natural phenomenon. To understand the natural phenomenon, actually we want to measure what is the mass of this object. Then what is the time taken by the object to reach the ground and the height from which it is falling. So, these quantities, mass, time and height, they are measurable quantities. Such quantities that can be measured is known as a physical quantity. And there are many physical quantities, mass, time, length, luminous intensity, viscosity, force, etcetera, etcetera. Now, take the example of mass. I am saying that the mass of an object is 2 kilogram. So, I will write m equal to 2 kilogram, or I can say mass m equal to 3.5 kilogram. Anyway, 2 kilogram means 2 into 1 kilogram, that is 2 times 1 kilogram, and 3.5 kilogram means 3.5 into 1 kilogram, that is 3.5 times 1 kilogram. So, actually here the physical quantity mass we are comparing with 1 kilogram, or this is the reference standard used in this measurement, and that is nothing but unit. So, kilogram is a unit of mass. There are different systems of unit. For example, kilogram is one of the units, gram is another unit, like that. And I am taking 1 kilogram, and that can be written as 1000 gram. So, kilogram is one unit, gram is some other unit. And here 1 is a numerical value, so that is n1, kilogram is one unit. So, I am writing n1 u1 equal to 1000 means numerical value denoting as n2, gram u2. So, any physical quantity can be represented by using a numerical value and unit. So, there are different systems of unit, and the important systems of units are CGS system, MKS system and FPS system. And in CGS system, the units of length, mass and time are centimeter, gram and second respectively. In MKS system, meter, kilogram and second, and in FPS system, foot, pound and second respectively. And nowadays we are using international system of units known as SI units. And in SI, there are 7 base quantities and corresponding units. They are mass with unit kilogram, length meter, time second, electric current ampere, thermodynamic temperature Kelvin, luminous intensity candela, amount of substance mole. And besides these 7 base units, there are 2 more units. One is for plane angle, nothing but radian, and another one is solid angle. The unit of solid angle is steradian. And the unit of any other physical quantity can be derived in terms of base units. Now, let us discuss how to derive the unit of some physical quantity. For example, the solar constant is defined as the energy incident per unit area per unit time on the surface of Earth. The unit of solar constant in SI is, solar constant is a defined quantity, and that is given in the question as solar constant is equal to energy per unit area per second. That means equation for solar constant is energy divided by area into time. So if we want to calculate the unit of solar constant, first we should know what is the unit of energy. And energy is given by the equation E is equal to, simple equation, half m v square. So unit of energy we can write as, half is a numerical value, m means unit in SI kilogram. Velocity, it is displacement by time, displacement meter, and time second. So m s raised to minus 1 all square, that's equal to kilogram m square s raised to minus 2. So energy, the unit is kilogram m square s raised to minus 2. Area is meter square, time is second. So unit of solar constant will become kilogram m square s raised to minus 2 divided by m square into time second. So this will get cancelled and answer is kilogram s raised to minus 3. Answer is kilogram s raised to minus 3, option D. Now solar constant is a physical quantity. The nature of the physical quantity can be described in terms of dimensions. The 7 base quantities in SI are the 7 dimensions of the physical world. They are represented by the square brackets, and in this chart, physical quantity mass, its dimension is represented by square bracket capital M, length capital L, time capital T, electric current capital A, thermodynamic temperature capital K, luminous intensity square bracket CD, and amount of substance square bracket mole. Now let us see how the dimensions of a physical quantity can be determined. Take the simple example of volume. And volume is given by the expression V equal to length into breadth into height. So volume is given by length into breadth into height. So dimensions of volume square bracket V is equal to dimensions of length L into breadth L into height again L, that's equal to L cube. And in mechanics we will write dimensions of volume is equal to m raised to 0 L cube T raised to 0. That is, volume is 0 dimension in mass, 3 dimension in length, and 0 dimension in time. Similarly, the dimension formula or equation of any physical quantity can be determined. And this equation is representing the dimensional equation of volume. And we can say the dimensional formula of volume is m raised to 0 L cube T raised to 0. Now a question, which one of the following physical quantity has the dimension formula m L square T raised to minus 2? Options: pressure, stress, strain, Young's modulus, and energy. Now we can start with the pressure. So pressure is given by pressure equal to force by area. So first we want to find out what is the dimensional formula of force. And force is given by F equal to mass into acceleration. So dimension equation of force equal to m, acceleration is L T raised to minus 2. Area is L square. So equation becomes pressure equal to force m L T raised to minus 2 divided by area L square. And that's equal to m L raised to minus 1 T raised to minus 2. Similarly, the dimensional equation of stress, strain, Young's modulus, and energy can be find out. You can see that energy, its dimensional formula is ML square T raised to minus 2, which is the correct answer. The above question may be like this also. Which of the following pairs of physical quantities does not have the same dimensional formula? Pressure and Young's modulus, EMF and electric potential, heat and work, torque and angular momentum, strain and relative density. The method is same. You have to calculate what are the dimensional formula of each quantity and you will get the answer as D. Or the question may be like this also. Which of the following pairs of physical quantities has the same dimensional formula? Same thing can repeat in the case of units also. Which of the following pairs of physical quantities does not have the same unit? Which of the following pairs of physical quantities has the same units? An important thing in the case of dimensional analysis is principle of homogeneity. In physics, you take an expression like this. Two physical quantities A and B added together to give C. We will write A plus B equal to C. So here, a physical quantity A is added to B giving C. That means the dimensions of A should be equal to dimensions of B equal to dimensions of C. And this is basically the principle of homogeneity. Now, the principle of homogeneity can be used to check whether an equation is dimensionally consistent or not. Take the simple example of x equal to ut plus half at square. So, the equation is x equal to ut plus half at square. We know that this equation is correct. Now, we can check whether it is dimensionally consistent or not. So, there are three terms. First one is x. Then, as per the principle of homogeneity, dimensions of x equal to dimensions of ut equal to dimensions of half a t square. Now, x means displacement and its dimensions is L. Ut, L t raised to minus 1 for velocity and t for time. Again, that is L. And last one is half a t square. Half is a number, a means acceleration, L t raised to minus 2 into t square. So, this equation is dimensionally consistent. Moreover, this is correct also. Now, suppose that this equation is like this. So, in this case also, dimensions of x equal to dimensions of ut equal to dimensions of a t square. So, it is dimensionally consistent, but we know that this equation is wrong. So, it is a limitation of dimensional analysis, one of the limitations. If an equation is dimensionally consistent, then that equation may be correct. And if an equation is correct, then that equation should be dimensionally consistent. Principle of homogeneity has many applications. One application is to find the dimensional formula of an unknown physical quantity. See this question. Velocity of a particle is given by v equal to a t plus b by t plus c. What is the dimensional formula of b? Here, a, b and c are physical quantities whose dimensional formula we do not know. V means velocity, t means time. So, as per the principle of homogeneity, dimensions of V must be equal to that of A t, must be equal to that of B by t plus c. We are focusing on B by t plus c. Anyway, B by t plus c should have the same dimensions of V. V is velocity and its dimensional equation is V is equal to L t raised to minus 1. Now, look at this term t plus c. T is time. So, dimensions of c should be same as that of time. So, denominator, the physical quantity should be time. That means c is having the dimensions of time. And now you look B. Anyway, L t raised to minus 1 should be the answer. That is equal to B divided by t plus c. So, t plus c, this is time and then B should be L. So, answer is L and option is M raised to 0, L T raised to 0. Now, the second application is to find the dimensional formula in a new system. So, look at this question. Find the dimensional equation of length in a system in which the fundamental units are force F, acceleration A and time T. And there are options. Now, the question says that the dimensional equation of length L in a new system, fundamental units are force, acceleration and time. So, we will write L is equal to, first one is force and we do not know what is the dimensions of force, take it as A. Second one is acceleration, so it is A, take it as B, and third one is time, take it as C. So, this is the base equations. Anyway, by using the dimension formula of F, A and T, we can find out what is the expression for A, B and C. So, L means length. So, dimension formula of length is M raised to 0, L T raised to 0, that is equal to force, it is M L T raised to minus 2, all raised to A, acceleration L T raised to minus 2, all raised to B, and time T raised to C. That is equal to, open the bracket, M raised to A, L raised to A, T raised to minus 2, L raised to B, T raised to minus 2B, T raised to C. And that is equal to, M raised to A, L raised to A plus B, and T raised to minus 2A plus C. So, at the left side, dimensions of mass is 0 and here is A. So, we can equate A equal to 0. Now, L raised to A plus B, L raised to 1, that means A plus B equal to 1. And last one is minus 2A plus C equal to 0. So, solving these three equations, we will get the values of A, B and C, and the answer is option C. In the third application, we can find the relation between different units in different systems. An example, let M1, L1, T1 be the fundamental units in SI and M2, L2, T2 be the units in CGS system. If n equal to 1 is the numerical value in SI, then what is the numerical value in CGS system? So, in this question, it is actually relating numerical value with the units. And we know that n1 u1 is equal to n2 u2. n1 is the numerical value in unit 1 and n2 that of in 2. So, anyway, while taking the dimensional equation of this expression, we can write n1, u1 means m1, l1, t1 with the dimensions A, B and C. That is equal to n2 into corresponding dimensions m2 raised to A, l2 raised to B, t2 raised to C, or n2 equal to n1 into, on simplification, m1 by m2 all raised to A, l1 by l2 all raised to B, and t1 by t2 all raised to C, so that n2 can be calculated. Now, look at this question. In a system of units, in which the unit of mass is a kilogram, unit of length is b meter and the unit of time is c second, the magnitude of calorie is. To do this problem, first we should know 1 calorie is equal to 4.2 joule. And another one, the dimensional equation of energy is m L square T raised to minus 2. Now, we know the equation for N2. N2 equal to N1 into M1 by M2 all raised to X, L1 by L2 all raised to Y, T1 by T2 all raised to Z equal to N1 means numerical value in SI. This is nothing but 4.2. So, 4.2 into M1, that is in SI, it is 1 kilogram divided by M2, that is in the CGS system, and as per the question, it is A all raised to X is nothing but 1, then L1 in SI it is 1 meter divided by L2 as per the question B all raised to Y is 2 and time T1 is 1, T2 is C all raised to C means Z means minus 2 or this is equal to 4.2 into 1 by A into 1 by B square into 1 by C raised to minus 2. So, answer is 4.2 C square divided by A B square. Dimensional analysis can be used in many other situations. Now, look at this question. If the unit of length, mass and time each be doubled, the unit of work done is increased by. Options are there. Anyway, work done and the dimensional equation of work done is force into displacement and that is given by m L square T raised to minus 2. As per the question, unit of length, mass and time each be doubled. So, this implies mass doubled, so it is 2m, length unit is doubled, so 2l all square, time also is get doubled, so 2t all raised to minus 2. On simplification, we will get 2m L square T raised to minus 2. So, the answer is option E. After dimensional analysis, we will discuss errors. The magnitude of the difference between the true value and the measured value is known as error. If A is the true value and delta A is the mean absolute error, then percentage error is given by delta A by A into 100%. The most important thing in the case of error calculation is combination of errors. And suppose that Z is equal to X plus or minus Y, then delta Z by Z into 100% is equal to delta X plus delta Y divided by X plus or minus Y 100%. And if Z is equal to XY or X by Y, delta Z by Z into 100% is equal to delta X by X plus delta Y by Y into 100%. And finally, if Z equal to X raised to N, then delta Z by Z into 100% is equal to N into delta X by X into 100%. Now, look at this question. In the determination of acceleration due to gravity, G using the formula T equal to 2 pi root L by G, the errors in the measurement of L and T are 1% and 2% respectively. The maximum percentage error in the value of G is. Anyway, the equation is given as T equal to 2 pi root L by G. And the question is, what is the maximum percentage error in the value of G? So, from this equation, we can write G is equal to 4 pi square L by T square. Now, we want to find out delta G by G into 100%. That is equal to 4 is a constant, pi square is again a constant. In the case of L, delta L by L into 100% plus T square 2 into delta T by T into 100%. It is equal to delta L by L into 100%. In the question, it is given as 1%. Therefore, 1% plus 2 into delta T by T is given as 2%. So, it is 2 into 2, 4% plus 1%, it is equal to 5%. So, answer is A. Now, one more question. Two resistors R1 equal to 3 plus or minus 0.1 ohm and R2 equal to 6 plus or minus 0.3 ohm are connected in parallel. The resistance of the combination is, anyway, two resistors are connected in parallel. So, equivalent resistance is given by 1 by R equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2, or R is equal to R1 R2 divided by R1 plus R2 equal to 3 into 6 divided by 3 plus 6, that is equal to 18 by 9 equal to 2 ohm. Now, in the answer, the error also is shown. So, now we want to find out what is delta R. And if you want to find out delta R, better follow through this particular steps. 1 by R equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2. So, on differentiation, delta R by R square is equal to delta R1 by R1 square plus delta R2 by R2 square. Therefore, delta R equal to R square into delta R1 by R1 square plus delta R2 divided by R2 square equal to R is 2 ohm. So, R square 4 into delta R1, as per the question, it is 0.1. So, 0.1 divided by R1 square 3 square plus delta R2 is 0.3. So, 0.3 divided by 6 square. So, you will get the answer as 0.08 ohm. The final answer is option A, which is 2 plus or minus 0.08 ohm. And finally, we are coming to significant figures and to order of magnitude. And these are the rules regarding the significant figures. All the non-zero digits are significant. All the zeros between two non-zero digits are significant. If the number is less than 1, the zeros on the right of the decimal point but to the left of the first non-zero digit are not significant. The terminal or trailing zeros in a number without a decimal point are not significant. The trailing zeros in a number with a decimal point are significant. Now, look at this question regarding the terminal or trailing zeros. And this is the question. A length is reported to be 4.700 meter, so that the trailing zeros are meant to convey the precision of measurement. If we change units, then length equal to 4.700 meter equal to 470.0 centimeter, 4700 millimeter equal to 0.004700 kilometer. What is the number of significant figures in the measured length in centimeter and in millimeter respectively? So, let us concentrate on centimeter and millimeter. Anyway, trailing zeros are not significant. That is our rule. But in this case, in terms of centimeter, 470.0 centimeter equal to 4700 millimeter. So, in this question, these trailing zeros are not significant if the question is not related to any unit change. But the question is related to a unit change, and in this situation, these trailing zeros should be considered, and hence in both cases, the number of significant figures is 4. So, answer is option